Brett Velicovich is a drone expert, frequent guest on the program. You haven't seen him recently because he's been in Africa hunting down illegal poachers of elephants. Well, he's here now. Brett is the author of the book Drone Warrior. Welcome. Good to see you back, Brett Velicovich. Tell me, what are you doing? How are you using drones to fight the poachers in Africa? Tell me.
Well, great to see you, Stuart. Thanks for having me back on. So don't be fooled by the nice suit and tie and clean shave. I've been living basically in the bushes of Africa for the last few months working on an elephant conservation project. And so I've been working with this organization called the Mara Elephant Project, which is a nonprofit in Kenya that focuses on hunting down specifically poachers of that are out there killing these elephants and using their ivory to fund some of their operations. And what we've been doing is taking basically advanced military technology, some of the same technology that I used to hunt down leaders of terrorist groups like ISIS and Al-Qaeda, and applying it here to the problem set. And what a lot of people don't realize is that the illicit wildlife trade is a $1 billion industry, and it's rampant with government corruption all along the entire chain. It disrupts livelihoods, it funds terrorist organizations, and it's a problem that we really need to get a handle on.
I used to live in Kenya, as a matter of fact, and I know the Maasai Mara quite well. So
Wonderful. What
you're talking about is sending up drones, which you can cover an enormous area, and you look down. What are you looking for? You're looking for the poachers?
Exactly. So what we're doing is a few different things. We're supporting rangers that are in the field, the Kenyan Wildlife Service, that are out there trying to hunt down these elements. We're providing them essentially with intelligence information and letting them know, hey, look, you may need to check out this area over here where individuals seem to be sneaking through these conservations. And so we have drones that have night vision technology that are able to do that. The other thing we're also able to do is even use the drone technology to even move elephants and corral them essentially and get them out of these danger areas where we know that they're being killed.
Did you have any successes to report? I mean, can you tell me right now that X number of poachers were nailed using your drones?
Yeah, I mean, look, it's a joint effort. It's not just the drone technology, but yes, we have specific stats where we have hundreds of poachers that are captured. We have them. We catch them in the act. They have ivory with them. And we have a number of different use cases, and you can actually go into maraelephantproject.org and see those specific cases where we are using advanced technologies, not only drones, but also artificial intelligence, GPS tech, to make sure that these species are protected.
Well, I think it's a fine thing, Brett. But before you leave us, I do want to talk to you about regulation of drones. Homeland Security Secretary Kirstjen Nielsen says drones are a national security concern, keep her up at night. She wants them regulated. Okay. What kind of regulation do you think would be appropriate, Brett? Because you've seen both, you've seen civilian use of this, you've seen military use of drones. What kind of regulation do you want to see?
Well, look, she's right. And this is a problem that definitely we need to get our head wrapped around here. So you may recall recently that the Venezuelan president was nearly assassinated when an off-the-shelf drone had explosives attached to it and nearly killed him at an event. And so that was a big wake-up call for the drone industry to come up with regulations, to come up specifically with technology that can be used to combat this. And what's happening now, I'm actually meeting with Senator Johnson, who is the chairman of the Homeland Security and Government Affairs Committee at the Senate, who has put together a bill that allows the Department of Homeland Security to have broader authorities to combat this threat. Because the fact is right now, law enforcement, they have the technology to combat it, but they don't have the authorities. And so the technology that exists out there is bogged down by regulations that make it so it can't be used in the right way to be employed here to protect our nation. So regulation is key, but right now the good news is that big government for once is coming together and actually trying to tackle the issue.
And now the good news is that you're using drones in a very good cause in Africa.
Yeah.
Well, then I can definitely get behind. Brett, you're all right. Thanks for joining us, sir. We'll see you again soon.
Thanks, Stuart. Appreciate it.